Hi, I'm Rafał. So people quite often ask me what kind of app I am using for off-road navigation when riding motorcycle. Is it any good while you don't have any mobile coverage? Can you download maps before you go? Is it good for GPX tracks navigation and so on and so on? And I will cover exactly that today. The app is OsmAnd, and I will try to show you a few tips and tricks on how to make it work for you. If you will find this video useful, please give it a thumbs up below. You might also want to consider subscribing, as most of the content that we are publishing is motorcycling related. If you already know this app, but the reason that you are here is that you would like to learn some more about one or two features, I will add chapters below for you to find the information quicker. I will talk about importing of GPX tracks, downloading maps, turn by turn GPX track following, and the settings for the GPX tracks following, map positioning while riding with navigation, how to set preference for unpaved roads, how to create and customize profiles, and finally, how to record your ride trace. The name of the app comes from OpenStreetMap Automated Navigation Directions. This is based on OpenStreetMaps, as the name suggests. It is not somehow connected to the OpenStreetMap Foundation. And what is and might be confusing for you is that there are a few options of this app. So there is a free option. It only allows you to download a few maps, not too many. Then there is a paid version. It costs around 25 euros, but it is often quite nicely discounted, so you can get it for half price sometimes or even less. And there's a subscription option that honestly, I think it's for the free version. If you just want a subscription for some time, I don't know, it's quite confusing and complicated, but I will cover the middle one, which is a paid version that allows you to download as many maps as you need, and all of them work offline, which is fantastic. But not everything about this app is like unicorns and rainbows, because the user interface, it is a bit outdated and there's a lot of room for improvement, but I will try to show you how I use it in the most simple way. Okay, so this is how the app would look like when you open it up for the first time. It will basically, in the first step, ask you to download the map of your neighborhood. I will skip that, and I will change the language of the app to English, so it would be a bit easier for you. And here we go. It is in English now. Let's get started. It is searching for map. I will download and skip. As soon as the map will be downloaded, then you will be able to see it in green. Now, you can use this app just for regular navigation, but I will be not covering that, as this is the same use case as you would have with Google Maps navigation or Waze. I am using this app for off-road navigation only, and also when we are traveling. This is my go-to app for navigation because it works offline. So I can download the map of any country that we are going to, call it Kyrgyzstan, call it Pakistan, whatever. And then you don't have to have a working mobile network for this navigation to be fully operational, including search of the destination. I believe also points of interest work offline if you download them earlier. So there are many options to choose from. For example, let me show you, there's a section here, download maps. So for example, let me go for Kyrgyzstan here, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, and then you see you can have standard maps, information from Wikipedia, which are the point of interest. It is very useful sometimes. You can download the whole country or just any given region. For example, incl region, it is about 104 megabytes. Let me download that in meters, download, and here it goes. Okay, so I have just downloaded a bit of Kyrgyzstan, and it should be already green on my map. Yeah, there you go. Actually, I have downloaded the whole country. Awesome. This is how you do it. Okay, we are back in Poland now. So, what I want to show you is how to add a GPX file track to OsmAnd first. So, that will be our first thing to do. I will use a Trans Euro Trail app as this has plenty of rich GPX tracks for riding off-road. And I will go for Poland. We will see a preview of all sections of Polish Trans Euro Trail, and I will open it in the OsmAnd. If you have just one app that is capable of working with the GPX tracks, it will open automatically in OsmAnd. And then you can see we have all the sections of Polish Trans Euro Trail. I will import four sections of this one track, and this is being stored in a place called My Places. Let me show you that from the perspective of the menu. So you have a menu here, down here, and then My Places. No favorites. So this is what the section that I told you about. The UI of this app is not so easy to work with. And then you have tracks on top. And if you expand this section of tracks, this is the place where you will find all of your GPX tracks. Right? And if I would like to go along this section, and that's another thing that we can already change. It is barely visible on the map now, but you can easily change it. So you go for palette of colors, then you can change the color to blue, then change the width of the line. And now you can see it much better. You can set it even to be a custom width. So you see, okay, now you can see the whole section. Now, from this level already, you can see down in the right corner at the bottom where you have a button for navigating. You can set the navigation already from this place. Now, I want to keep my speed camera's points of interest, of course. And when I choose this option, the app is drawing a navigation to the start of this track. As you can see here, it is going south to the green flag, which is a start of the track, and then it will turn by turn navigate along this Trans Euro Trail track. Okay, so I have the GPX tracks on my map already, and now I want to first get to the starting point and then be able to navigate along the track. So I go for navigation. Then I choose the settings, as the settings are important here. I want to follow a track. I am choosing the Trans Euro Trail Poland Section 3, as this is the one that we have placed on the map. And now, what is important? I want to be navigating to the start of the track, right? But if you're in different position, you can choose a different position than mine. For example, you're in Częstochowa. You want to, which is the name right here in the middle, or in Kraków. Maybe you want to get to the nearest point on the track and then decide if you want to go left or right, which is of course very convenient. What is important that every GPX tracks has a pre-programmed beginning and the end. So depending on if you want to go east or west, in that case, you can reverse the track direction here. So in my case, I would probably go to the start of the track and follow the direction that is already pre-programmed on the track. You can start navigating already. It will take you to the beginning of the track and then it will start navigating along the GPX tracks. I want to show you like two or three very useful features of this app as well. So first of all, I go for settings, then selected profile, driving, OSM and profile, and then to general settings and map orientation. So my preferred setting here is movement direction. So not north set as a default, not compass direction, always movement direction. That is very helpful. Then going back to the main page of the settings, I go for driving and I have navigation settings. And In route planners, you can set the preferred roads to be unpaved, which is very useful if you're looking for some off-road adventure. And since we are riding motorcycles, we can change the look of the icon of the profile, which is a very cosmetic thing, but it looks like nice. So I'm now in the I'm configuring profile for driving. I will go for navigation settings, navigation type, and I will change here to motorcycle because why not? Right? So I have motorcycle type and I can configure appearance of this app. So if you have a Honda, you can set it to red. If you have a Kawasaki, you can set it to green. I have a Husqvarna, so I will set it to maybe blue. And then you can choose the icon if it's a road bike or dirt bike. I want to have a dirt bike safe. And now I am driving a profile that is for motorcycle. I have a motorcycle profile for driving. And if I have set up in this profile that I am looking for unpaved roads, then you can quickly switch between profiles. You might want to have a road profile or off-road profile for this navigation app. And it is quite useful. And one last feature that I want to tell you about, this is called trip recording. You will find it in the menu under plugins. There is trip recording. If you ever got lost somewhere, this will allow you to go back using your own recorded path. So that's one feature that could be helpful. Or if you are taking a very long trip and you want to just record the way you went, this will also be helpful. So if you go into this trip recording plugin, you first need to turn it on. And then you can go for settings. Then you can decide how often it should record your position. Should it be recording if you are not moving or just stop recording, and so on and so on? Should it be enabled automatically or manually? And if you have this trip recording enabled, then in the top right corner of the app, you will see a record button. Again, depending on how you're going to set it up, you can do it just manually, or it can record your trip automatically every time you use navigation. A very good feature. So, to wrap up, I am using this app for turn-by-turn navigation along GPX tracks. The example could be Trans Euro Trail. The other use case is when we are going somewhere far, where we know that the mobile coverage will be weak or no mobile coverage at all, then we are downloading the maps and using the navigation in the airplane mode, actually. No other radios are working except for the GPS one. I sometimes use it to look to more unpaved roads, so I am asking the app to take me off of the pavement, and I believe it is also very useful to record your ride trace. For example, if you get lost somewhere, you can find your way back, or you can then share the trace with others if they want to follow your path. What I also like about it is that it works both for Android and iOS. And in regards to Android phones, it doesn't have to be a very new phone. It can be something that you had been lying around for 4 years, and now you want to use it for navigation on your bike. So just give it a try. You can see it working in action in many of our videos. I will put a link somewhere here for you to find them. If you have any questions, please write them down below in the section of for the comments. Okay, thank you for watching. Bye.